Okay, this right here is a brand new watch, and I'm testing the brand new watch here. Take a look at it. See that it's moving at a normal rate of speed. I'm testing this watch with this lodestone. This is iron ore. Yeah, natural magnetic mineral lodestone. See? Testing it with a lodestone. Hey, I only paid $1.25 for this. Magnetite. Okay, it's a natural magnet. Notice that the watch does not speed up or slow down. People keep saying that if they put a magnet next to the watch will start moving. Well, if it moves, it moves at a normal rate of speed. Okay, now let's take a look at something else. Remember, this is a brand new watch. Let's turn the HDR on. There we go, it's on. And let's put this watch next to this thing. See what happens. Takes a while for it to start spinning. Okay. Okay, now your question is going to be, why is there a delay? Okay, I don't know why there's a delay. Why is there a delay when I turn on an old tube radio and the tubes have to warm up? I have no idea, but it takes the HDR a certain amount of time to warm up and start generating the time field. Now, I don't have any proof, but I believe, and I might be wrong, that this has to do with warming up of the time coils. Maybe I'm wrong. Here, let me show you what the time coils are. Now, some people have told me that the time coils are phone cord. No, they're guitar cord. Let me show you some phone cord here for comparison. Okay. This is phone cord. See? They may look the same, but they're different. You try putting 120 watts, or 120 volts, I mean, of AC through a phone cord, which is meant for DC, and low voltage, and you will burn up the phone cord. You can't use phone cords with the HDR. It uses guitar cord. Guitar cord can handle 120 volts of AC. So it's, you know, it's a different story.